I made the acquaintance of a book dealer by the name of C.E. Rappaport up on the top of the, at the very top of the Spanish Steps in Rome, up on the Via Sistina. And I told him what I was interested in. Of course, I was there as a soldier. This was in 1944, and this was during the summer that we were stationed. Our hospital was stationed in Rome. And I was wandering around up there one day on a free hour, and we were talking about rare books, and he said, "I'll let you know if something really good comes along." Well, I'd been home after the war was over several months, and I received a cablegram. He said, "We have a copy of Aeselius Fabrica, believe it or not, but I'm embarrassed to tell you, the price is $740. I know that's an awful price, but this is a very famous book. And if you don't take it, you will rue the day one of these days."
Thank you. first part of the history of
Vesalius introduced a new way of teaching, the hands-on method. Do it yourself. Stand by the cadaver, demonstrate it, and say, I don't care what Galen said in 1000 AD. You can see right here that there are no holes in the septum of the heart. Blood could not possibly pass from one side to another through such holes because there are no holes. And he also had the temerity, by that sort of action, to break with old traditions. Nobody dared to say something new. You would be penalized no end. And he was. And it ruined his life. He died at age 50. And so... His method of teaching and his departure from the old and having the temerity and the willingness and the bravery to try something new, that's what Vesalius stands for.
Thank
Thank you.
Harvey is the beginning of physiology. Harvey proved that the heart circulation was a circular affair, and that just by a mere figuring it out on a piece of paper numerically, you could prove that this was true. But he is the first man who demonstrated, of course, he was an anatomist, you know. Harvey was an anatomist primarily. He taught anatomy in London. But he did this, he collected all these notes over 13 or 14 years, and finally this strange character, Robert Flood, said, you better get those notes published, because this is something new and right. And Harvey said, no, I'll lose my practice, I will be ostracized. Both came true, but he finally had it published, and this little fellow over in Frankfurt, Robert Fitz, or William Fitz, said, this cheap little thing, I'll print it on the cheapest, poorest, least expensive paper I can find, which he did. It's a miserable little book. It's ugly, only 68 pages of text, poor Latin, and yet it is probably, most historians, I would say, think that Harvey is a more important book in the history of medicine than Vesalius. I don't agree with that. Of course, I have a streak of anatomy down my back that wide.
Thank you. Thank you.